Thank you. vou chamar o amigo Osvaldo Palhinha, que aqui vem também todos os anos como mestre de cerimónias, para reconhecer algumas pessoas que aqui estão presentes. Muito obrigado pela vossa presença, e tudo isto é feito com humildade e em louvor ao Divino Espírito Santo. Muito obrigado.
My friend, first words will be for Manuel and Laurinda Vieira, our comendador. I'm so pleased to be here since the first year is the 8th year, together with the family. I have nothing but thanks to give to God, to the Holy Spirit, and to this family. They're absolutely amazing in our community. We're like brothers, and I'm so honored to be here with all of you. Thank you. My first introduction is for an old friend. A friend that keeps being re-elected over and over again, and is a Portuguese, is a first generation Portuguese, but we love them so much. We care so much that we keep re-electing them, and it's an honor and a pleasure for me to say that he got re-elected again. So we're gonna have him for another 2 years at least in Washington. It gives me a great pleasure to give to all of you, my good friend and the friend of the family Vieira, our congressman of the 16th district, Jim Costa. Put your hands together. We have a pleasure to have great people over here being re-elected, and people that I've been so pleased to know for the last few years because they're very good friends of the family. We have Rodrigo Espinosa, now the gentleman, he is supervisor of the first district. And I told him a little while ago, stand up. A supervisor, I don't know if you guys know about it, but he's the man with the power, he has the money, he's a supervisor. So be friendly with him, because it's very important. Give your hand again to our new supervisor of first district. We have with us the new mayor, with his lovely wife, the mayor of Livingston, Jim Soria. We have the mayor pro team, Grupo, that's a name that, please stand up and forgive me if I don't pronounce your name correctly, Grupo Swama. Thank you, sir, and I apologize again. And this is important. Do me a favor, keep an eye on our Monsignor, because sometimes he drives like crazy, you know? And I understand now why he got so many tickets on the past. We have the pleasure of having with us the chief of the police of Livingston, Mr. Ruben Chaves, good man. I have our good friend of the port. He keeps being re-elected, I believe, because I see him in all the functions. He's my good friend, Tommy Silva. He's the Secretary General of Livingston, I believe. Yeah. Okay. I have to apologize, because you know why? I see another gentleman over there, and I don't have your introduction. You see, this is the moment. No, you're fine, thank you. At least, should I know your name? You're Portuguese. Stand up, please. You're first generation. Great, hey, everybody put their hands together for you.
John Costa.
Okay, if he follows, are you guys cousins or something like that? No. Okay, now I have my good friend, Dr. Manuel Tencourt. It seems like when there's an important function, there's one person that is always there, because not only is a good friend of the family, Vieira, but he's a good friend of the community. If you need something, you just call Dr. Manuel Tencourt, he knows everything. Dr. Manuel Tencourt. Is also a director of Luso America. My good friend, and we did television together for the first time in the state of California for the great RTP International. and was a pleasure to work with this gentleman. He's so good. He's prime ticket, believe me. He is, right now, o Conselho das Comunidades Portuguesas, é vice-presidente mundial das comunidades portuguesas, não é brincadeira nenhuma, ele tem realmente uma posição importantíssima. Eu não sei se a posição de todos estes títulos é mais importante do que o bebé que ele tem, que é absolutamente adorável, e eles adoram ele e a senhora, a sua esposa, o meu querido amigo Nelson Ponta Garça. Da nossa rádio e televisão portuguesa Açores, dá a impressão que a gente começamos realmente a habituar-nos a ver esta cara. É que toda a gente crema, toda a gente que é portuguesa ou açoriana, ah, pá, eles só dão isto, só dão aquilo, só dão aquele outro. Mas de repente aparece aqui o Vasco. E nós começamos a habituar-se à sua cara, à sua forma simples de contactar connosco, sua forma amável de se integrar na comunidade portuguesa. E pela primeira vez nós temos alguém que vem dos Açores, inclusive até do continente português e da Ilha da Madeira, que nós começamos a habituar-nos à sua cara, à sua maneira de ser, à sua amabilidade e à sua simplicidade. Eu tenho o imenso prazer de apresentar a vocês um colega, o jornalista da RTP Açores, está com o senhor, a sua esposa, o meu querido amigo Vasco Pernas, e esposa Diana Pérez. Pernas. Eu tenho aqui alguns jornalistas, um deles é o Zé Ávila, diretor do nosso jornal português. E eu agora vou aproveitar, já que as sopas continuam a cozer, eu avisei que não sei cantar, há quem te singue, está bem? Mas vou tentar estender isto mais um minuto. Há uma coisa aqui connosco, portugueses, na Califórnia, que é fundamental. É que nós cremamos sempre das coisas que existem. E quando elas deixam de existir, a gente deita as mãos à cabeça e começamos a dizer, ah pá, mas como é que aquilo desapareceu? E as coisas vão desaparecendo às vezes sem a gente perceber. É tal e qual uma typewriter desapareceu, ninguém deu por isso. E de repente, depois mais tarde, as pessoas dizem, ah, e aquele teclado que eu tinha velhinho, aquele era tão fácil de trabalhar com ele. E então, nós temos a Tribuna Portuguesa, mas precisamos, obviamente, de muito mais assinantes, senão aquilo quebra mesmo. E por um dólar ou dois por semana, come on, vamos ser assinantes do único jornal português que nós temos a oeste do Mississippi, Tribuna Portuguesa. Eu sou o publisher, José Ávila está aqui, uma salva de palmas para ele, pelo trabalho que ele tem feito bem da comunidade. Nós temos aqui dois videógrafos e esta gente, ano após ano após ano, trabalham a bem da nossa comunidade portuguesa. Eles merecem todos uma salva de palmas, como os senhores que estão aqui a gravar, como o coro, como toda esta gente que participou neste adorável dia, que foi absolutamente extraordinário. Thank you.
A Dream Limousine é uma empresa de limousines que coloca ao seu dispor todo o requinte e distinção que necessita para assinalar ocasiões especiais. A Dream Limousine conta com o profissionalismo e responsabilidade dos seus condutores para lhe proporcionar um dia especial. Além do inglês, os nossos condutores falam português, possibilitando uma melhor comunicação com os nossos clientes. Com a Dream Limousine, o seu dia especial será em grande estilo. Sedans, stretch limousines até 20 pessoas. Party Bus, serviço de aeroporto, proms, casamentos, quinceanero, suite 16, night outs e excursões para prova de vinhos. Reserve 6 horas e terá a sétima grátis. Dream Limousine, a servir o Val Central e a área da Bahia. Na Califórnia, telefone 1-800-998-9248 ou aceda à internet www.dreamlimo.net, porque há sonhos que se podem realizar.
Sem mais, senhoras e senhores, Zé da Veia. Ele diz que não quer sair, não ouviu bastante. Senhoras e senhores, por favor, Zé da Veia. Foi.
Desgraçado sou eu.
Tu é que és o desgraçado?
Ah! Não estás a ver? Meteste-me outra vez naquela bocaria daquela mala e lá estou eu ali engarrafado. Estavas com medo.
Até talvez tivesse medo. Devias estar no bar.
É verdade. Epa! Tem muita gente aqui hoje.
Por acaso ainda tenho gente bastante. Tenho uma quantidade.
Está cheio.
Ah, tem muita gente, realmente tem muita gente.
Ô Zé, se fosse para trabalhar não aparecia ninguém. Para comer e beber está tudo.
Ah, estás a pensar, não é?
Epá!
Diz lá.
Mas afinal onde é que tu hoje?
Estás aqui, na casa.
Sim.
Do senhor comendador Manuel Eduardo Vieira.
Esse gajo?
Sim.
Epa, mas isso é um nome de cumprir. Porquê que não disse só o rei da batata?
Mas também devia ter dito.
Mas, é, mas espera aí, não é só isso.
O que é?
Não é só o rei da batata, é o rei da batata doce. Isso é muito importante.
Está bem.
Olha, vamos lá ver. E quando se é rei da batata, vocês dizem doce. Vamos experimentar. Rei da batata?
Doce!
Olá, tem gente.
São bons.
São bons. Se eles são bons assim para falar, como são bons para trabalhar, ia ser bom para cavar batatas hoje.
Realmente?
Bem, então estás a gostar. Uma maravilha. Olha, ouvi dizer que o ano passado, ainda vim aqui acima, choveu muito.
Por acaso é verdade, por acaso o ano passado choveu.
Há de dizer ao teu amigo, ao rei da batata, para convidar todos os anos, não há chuva.
Ora bem.
Olha, ele está aqui sentado à frente.
Oh! Eu não sequer tinha visto.
Poxa, andas meio cego, não é?
É surreal estar aqui com tanta gente boa e só mesmo o nosso comendador Manuel Eduardo Vieira consegue juntar tanta gente boa de cá e de lá, unir os açorianos de cá, da outra costa e de Portugal. Eu, quando fui eleito Conselheiro das Comunidades Portuguesas cá, estabeleci três prioridades principais: melhores voos com a SATA para Portugal, uma melhor relação com o RTP e depois mais recenseamento, mais interesse da vossa parte. E hoje temos aqui a SATA, temos aqui a RTP Açores representada. Estamos, na verdade, a fazer um reforço com Portugal de uma forma muito
A Dream Limousine é uma empresa de limousines que coloca ao seu dispor todo o requinte e distinção que necessita para assinalar ocasiões especiais. A Dream Limousine conta com o profissionalismo e responsabilidade dos seus condutores para lhe proporcionar um dia especial. Além do inglês, os nossos condutores falam português, possibilitando uma melhor comunicação com os nossos clientes. Com a Dream Limousine, o seu dia especial será em grande estilo. Sedans, stretch limousines até 20 pessoas. Party Bus, serviço de aeroporto, proms, casamentos, quinceanero, suite 16s, night outs e excursões para prova de vinhos. Reserve 6 horas e traz sétima grátis. Dream Limousine, a a servir o Val Central e a área da Bahia. Na Califórnia, telefone 1-800-998-9248 ou aceda à internet www.dreamlimo.net, porque há sonhos que se podem realizar.
Medication. and I'm thinking about the dinner, and so I drive up to the window and I give her my name, and you have to remember that Mary, my wife, tells me that I don't hear well, or I have selective hearing. I'm not quite sure which one it is, but it's one or the other. So I get up to the window and I tell her my name and my age, the date of birth, as you know, and her lips are moving, but I can't hear anything. And I go, oh shoot, I think I'm deaf. I just can't hear anything. And she's going like this. What's going on here? And finally, I realize, she said, roll down your window. Now, those of you who are my age, when we wanted to roll down the window, we didn't go like this, we went like this. So that tells you that things have changed. I would like to start with the executive committee of the foundation. They've done a lot of work, they do a lot of work behind the scenes, and all of it is to help the young people and to provide scholarships. So I'd like to start with the executive committee, president, Professori. Please wait to applaud until I'm all done. Professori Lina Smith, president, please stand. Vice president, Ms. Eileen Faria. Secretary de Língua Portuguesa, Dr. Hilário Carvalho Costa. English secretary, Ms. Michelle Machado. And the treasurer, who's not here, I think he's out of the country, Mr. Luis Oliveira. Please give him a round of applause. I would like to also present the directors of the foundation, and some of them, again, could not be here, but I'll call their names. So I'd like to ask them to stand, and please remain standing. Professora Cecilia Areias, Professor Isabel Cabral Johnson, Mr. Manuel Lima, Dr. Sergio B. Pereira, Dr. Alicia Pratt, Mr. John Sai, Ms. Maria Hortensia Silveira, Ms. Emilia Simões, Mr. Paulo Soares, Mrs. Fatima Valenzuela, and the accountant, Mr. Albert Nunes. Please give him a round of applause. We have some people here from the university, and we have an excellent working relationship with the university. We appreciate them being here. I know that this is a long evening for them, so we're very, very appreciative. I've already introduced the president, but I'd like to also introduce the Vice President for University Advancement, Dr. Michelle Lati. The Dean of the College of Education, Kinesiology and Social Work, Dr. Adman Murray. Assistant Professor of Portuguese and Spanish, Dr. Renato Alvim. We also have some people here from the local school districts, the superintendent of the Turlock Unified School District, Ms. Dana Salas Trevithan. She is a big supporter of the Portuguese program. I can tell you that even before she became superintendent, when they needed a Portuguese teacher at the high school, she was calling people. She was, do you know anybody that, terrific. So we really appreciate that, Dana. Thank you very much. And we also have the superintendent of the Hilmar School District, who's also part of the foundation, and she's also a great supporter of the Portuguese program, of course, because she's part of the community, so she's one of us. So we don't pay as much attention to her. This is like a brother or sister, you know how that is. Ms. Isabel Cabral Johnson. We
We appreciate that some of our local representatives and senators have sent glasses of wine back. have sent representatives, and so representing Assemblymember Kristen Olson and Congressman Jeff Denham, we have Sandra Losa and Russell Fowler. Did you wave, Sandra? I didn't see it. And representing Assembly, he's a senator. Senator Canella, we have Brenda Herbert. And Brenda brought us a beautiful resolution that is being displayed in front of the podium here. So Brenda, thank you very much. We appreciate that. It's a resolution commemorating our 25th anniversary. And representing Senator Tom Berryhill, we have Pat O'Brien. And Pat also brought us a special certificate recognizing our 25th anniversary. Thank you, Pat. But if this foundation is in existence today, I think we owe it in great part to Mrs. Jim Munch. We did recognize him posthumously, I think, 2 years ago. There's one other gentleman who also passed away, and he also contributed generously to the foundation. He passed away this year, Mr. Artur Tumaj. And so this time I'd like to recognize the founders of the foundation and the first board of directors. And as I call their names, if they would come out and come up to the front, we'd like to get a picture of them. I know some of them are not here because they have other commitments, they are out of town, but I'll call their names anyway. So Mr. Cleves Alvarez, yours truly, Dr. Mary Borba, Isabel Cabral Johnson, Dr. Alman Kwasha, come on, sir, coming up. We don't want to miss that. Yes, please. I'm sorry, that sounded, that tone, I didn't mean that. I think we just wanted to get in there. Sorry about that. I already said Mr. Stephen Mach, Shislin Reich, Mary Salvador, Dr. Duarte Silva, and Maria Hortensia Silveira. These were the founders. Now, please. The first board of directors was also Ms. Michelle Marcus, President Isabel Cabral Johnson, Vice President Dr. Norman Bosch, the Secretary of English, Manuel Lima, Secretary of Portuguese, Luis Oliveira, Treasurer, Jorge Esvelho, yours truly, Dr. Rosa Bettencourt, Josué Veiga, Maria Hortensia Silveira, and the
Senhoras e senhores, eu apresento-vos os cidadãos do ano de 2016 da Fundação Portuguesa de Educação do Centro da Califórnia. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2016 Portuguese Education Foundation of Central California Citizens of the Year, the Hillmar Holy Rosary New Church Executive Committee with co-chairs Carlos Rocha and Arlene Vieira, as well as other members.
Woo! Can we move to that door is not so good.
Em nome da Comissão Executiva, nós agradecemos a Fundação Portuguesa de Balação do Centro de Califórnia. Esta homenagem a nós foi um trabalho de amor. Foi um trabalho que nós estamos muito honrados em ter feito e foi composto pela Comissão, onde três partes de nós, dos portugueses, de origem portuguesa, que demos o nosso trabalho, as nossas horas, mas não podia ter sido feita sem o apoio dos parteanos, sem o apoio dos vizinhos, sem o apoio da comunidade. Portanto, Obrigado pela homenagem e obrigado às todas as pessoas que fizeram isto possível para que pudéssemos construir a tal nova igreja. Obrigado.
On behalf of the entire committee, I also would like to thank the Portuguese Education Foundation for this honor. We truly were blessed as a committee. It was the hand of God that got us through all of it, because as a committee, we really didn't know what we were doing, but we had the complete support of our parish, our surrounding communities, and trust. And in God we trusted, we prayed a lot, and it got done. And it was probably, speaking for all of us, one of the biggest things we'll ever be involved in our lives. So once again, thank you.
And now we are going to honor the student of the year. And to make the introduction, I'd like to call on Ms. Isabel Cabral Johnson, superintendent of the Ilmari Unified School District.
Boa noite a todos. É um meu prazer para hoje falar pouco sobre o nosso estudante do ano. Our recipient graduated from Ilmar High School in 2009. So it is a special privilege for me to introduce him. Este jovem é filho de pais que emigraram para os Estados Unidos da Graciosa. His parents' sacrifice was rewarded as he graduated from California State University Stanislaus this past spring. He is involved in the Portuguese culture and has already contributed much to his community, especially in the area of music and dance. It is my great pleasure to wish a happy birthday and to award the Portuguese Education Foundation of Central California Student of the Year Award to Jason Gabriel Melo.
Came here to the States like most parents have. I'm sure you guys haven't been, you know, you guys know the story. They immigrated to a better life out here. They wanted to have a better opportunity for their kids. And my mom and dad have always explained that to me growing up. They've always wanted the best for their kids. They're just so selfless. And I know many of you parents, your grandparents, and sisters are the same way. You guys want the best for your children. You guys want more opportunity. You just want a successful life, so I appreciate them so much. They've been working at Foster Farmers for 40 years exactly. They've helped me so much. I've gone to college, worked at Target, working, you know, 25 hours a week, $8 an hour. I couldn't financially set myself to Santa Rosa. I couldn't pay for college. And it's just such a blessing that they helped me out so much throughout the years and continue to do so. You know, I mean, they're just the most hardworking people that I know, working overtime all the time, working weekends all the time, just to put me through school. So, my bye, muito obrigado, I love you guys very much. And last but not least, I want to recognize the students today that got their award. You guys are the future. We are the future. The sky's the limit for us. I want to advocate, go further into education, push yourself for education, but please also don't forget about your Portuguese roots, your Portuguese ancestors. Don't forget about your culture, the language, the heritage that our Portuguese immigrants and our ancestors have thrived so hard for.
To present the Educator of the Year, I'd like to call upon Dr. Mary Borba.
Good evening. It is my honor to introduce this year's Educator of the Year, Albertina Silva Costa. It's been long due. Albertina is one of the most dedicated and expert teachers that I have observed. Over the years, I have been in her classroom on many occasions as a colleague and as a university professor, accompanying teacher candidates to observe expert teaching. É prazer para mim apresentar esta noite a professora Albertina Silva Costa. Além de ser uma professora exemplar, ela é casada com Elmano Costa, professor na Universidade de Stanislaw, e é mãe de dois jovens excepcionais, o Paulo e o Daniel.
E foi um segredo. Primeira coisa, eu dou graças a Deus. Sem eu, não posso fazer nada. Segunda coisa, quero agradecer esta honra à Fundação. Muito obrigada. Terceira coisa, a minha primeira professora a estar aqui comigo foi a minha mãe. Uma salva de palmas. A minha mãe, com os seus 85 anos, tem mais sabedoria que eu tenho. Muito mais. Também quero agradecer a minha família. Sem eles, tenho o seu apoio, o meu marido Almano, os meus filhos Paulo e Daniel, a minha irmã, os meus irmãos, todos, todos. Muito obrigada. And lastly, I would like to thank my students. But they are the most important part of this. Those of you who are educators know this is the truth. Our children teach us much more than we ever teach them. And for them, and for all their families that support them. Muito obrigada.
To be here on my face, not the lead force move, but thank you so much for having me here, and congratulations to all the winners. Thank you.
Well, Mr. Mayor, if this makes you feel any better, look at me. I'm full-blooded Portuguese, and I can't hear any better than you can. So.
Alrighty.
Jason, how you doing, buddy?
Good, I am fantastic. How are you?
All right. Hey, how does it feel receiving all these different awards and honors? Boy, at your age of 25.
25, yeah. My birthday today, so it's been such an experience and an honor receiving the Student of the Year here at the Portuguese Scholarship Foundation. I've been a recipient for the past 4 years, and I've always looked up to the Educator of the Year, the Citizen of the Year, and all the different recognitions that some of these important, hardworking people in the community get. And for me, just to be recognized and even to be considered, to be honest, is such a privilege and such an honor. And I can think of so many other people that are well deserving of this award, and I'm just very grateful and thankful that they've thought of me.
Hey, thank you very much for taking this few minutes to talk to us.
No
and
problem.
If there's anything special you want to mention, any fest that's coming up, anything that the band is doing that you want the community to be part of?
Yeah, well, we have our annual, the Matança do Porco that we've been doing for many, many years consecutively. It's on January 3rd, it's a Friday. So tickets are being made for that if anyone's interested in that. And yeah, I mean, push forward to our Portuguese community, and thank you to all the organizations that help out and make this culture what it is and how great our heritage is, and to really preserve our roots. And like I had said earlier, it's kind of up to people my age, kind of up to the future generations to go ahead and push that forward and make sure we keep these Pentecosts running another 100 years like they have been, and it's really down to us.